Power of God, everybody!
Lord, I come to you. Let my heart be changed, renewed, flowing from the grace that I found in you.
What did I ask, Tom?
Lord, I come to know the weaknesses I see.
Thank you. Of all nations,
Our topic today will be forgive and you will be forgiven, a healing journey of forgiveness. But before I start my talk, I would like you to watch this video, okay?
Thank you.
That will be the first point of our discussion and talk for this afternoon. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. The healing journey of forgiveness. Let me start with what Matthew chapter 6, verse 15 said. For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. Whereas if you do not forgive the trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. Matthew 6, chapter 4, verses 14 and 15. Can you kind of recommend that? Thank you. I have no doubt that many of you are carrying some deep wounds and that you've carried for months, maybe even years. When you think about the person who hurt you, still as fresh as if it happened this morning. The pain is still there, and you're still filled with resentment. And you say, why in the world should I forgive that person who hurt me so much? You have no idea how much they hurt me. Why should I offer grace to that person? Be silent your phone, please. You ought to do it for three reasons. One, you need to be gracious to others and forgive those who've hurt you because God has been gracious to you. You will never have to forgive anyone else more than Jesus Christ has already forgiven you. You should consider that you haven't always gotten what you deserved either. God has been gracious with me and you. Now, be gracious to others. You need to forgive others because the alternative is bitterness. This is very, very right, okay? Scientists tell us that resentment is the unhealthiest emotion there is. It always hurts you more than anybody else. Resentment will not change the past, and it won't solve the problem. It doesn't even make you feel better. And in fact, it makes you feel worse. The Bible says, look after each other so that none of you fails to receive the grace of God. Watch out that no poisonous root of bitterness grows up to trouble you, corrupting many. That's so powerful verse from the Bible. And remember, the last one is, you need to show grace and to forgive others because God expects you to do it. In Matthew 6 again, for if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if ye forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. Twice. It was repeated. Jesus says, we cannot receive what we are unwilling to give. Therefore, if we want to be completely forgiven by God, we must first forgive. Okay? The complete forgiveness or the total forgiveness God will give us is when we start forgiving others also. If you say, I could never forgive that person, then I hope you never sin. If you just don't feel like doing it, do it anyway. because it's the right thing to do. The reason why some of you have a hard time forgiving is because you don't feel forgiven. I want you to see this video that speaks so much of this life.
To imagine.
Whenever you start praying, If you have anything against anyone, forgive him, that your Father in heaven may also forgive you your trespasses. And another one, do not judge, and you will not be judged. Do not condemn, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. God is saying that it is in our own best interest to forgive. He is not talking about what is in the best interest of the person who needs to be forgiven. We are the ones who God is trying to protect. We are the ones who receive the most benefit from forgiving or forgiveness, not the other person. A spirit of forgiveness or of unforgiveness complicates the compromises our daily walk with God. Forgiving others releases us from anger and allow us to receive the healing that we need. The whole reason God has given us specific direction is because He does not want anything. He does not want anything to stand between us and Him. God's love for us is beyond our comprehension. Forgiving others spares us from the consequences of living out of an unforgiving heart. My dear friends, forgiving others does not carry with a single decision that we need to ponder. God has not qualified one sin as being more grievous to Him than another. And He has not qualified one sin committed against us as warranting forgiveness and another not. For example, God is not saying, if a person lies to you or steals from you, you should forgive him. But if they abuse you or harm your child, you can hold them in unforgiveness. He is saying, forgive everyone always and do it immediately. Forgiving others often takes time. I have a story that perhaps few people have heard. It's about the two of the three tenors, Plácido Domingo and Jose Carreras. You know them? And the other one is Pavarotti, right? Even those who never visited Spain know of the rivalry between Catalanes and Madrileño. It's just like in the Philippines. The Mindanao area wanted to be by themselves, separated from the rest of the Philippines, okay? To say like this, since the Catalanes are fighting for their autonomy from a Madrid-dominated Spain, it so happened that Plácido Domingo is Madrileño, and Jose Carreras is Catalanes, or Catalan. For political reasons, in 1984, Carreras and Domingo became enemies. Being that they were very popular and much sought after around the world, both stated in their contracts that they would perform only if the other was not invited. Okay? So in 1987, Carreras met up with an enemy more implacable than this rival Plácido Domingo. He was taken by surprise with a terrible diagnosis, leukemia. His fight against cancer was a painful one. He was subjected to numerous treatments. Besides having a bone marrow transplant and blood transfusions that forced him to travel to the United States once a month. Unable to work under these conditions, though he possessed a considerable fortune, the high cost of his trips and medical, he discovered, depleted his finances. But at the end of his financial capability or ability, he discovered a foundation in Madrid, Hermosa Foundation, the sole purpose of which was to support of treatment for the sufferers of leukemia. Thanks to the support from the Hermosa Foundation, Carreras conquered the disease and returned to singing. Once again, he attained to an elevated and deserved status and attempted to join the foundation, the Hermosa Foundation. Reading their bios, he discovered that the founder of Hermosa, the leading contributor and president of the foundation was Plácido Domingo. He later found out that Plácido had originally formed this organization to help him, solely him, with his treatment, but had chosen to remain anonymous in order to not humiliate him in accepting help from his enemies. But the most moving part of this story is their encounter. Surprising Plácido at one of his performances in Madrid, Carreras interrupted the event and humbly knelt on his feet, asking forgiveness and publicly thanked him. Plácido helped him up, and with a big hug, they sealed the beginning of a great friendship. In an interview with Plácido Domingo, a reporter asked him why he had created the Hermosa Foundation at a time when, besides benefiting an enemy, he had helped the only other artist that was his competition. His answer was short and definite. We cannot afford to lose a voice like that. Don't kapit-paki-fade out. I'm telling you the truth because I want you to see the clippings of their encounter. wanted to show you the clippings of their encounter. It's so touching to see that moment when Carreras had to ask forgiveness and thank Placido.
This is a true story of human kindness and forgiveness, and should serve us an example and inspiration. We have a divine example for forgiving others. God knew that man needed forgiveness. So he sent his son Jesus to deliver all of mankind from eternal consequences of their sins. Colossians says, bear with each other and forgive one another. If any of you has a grievance against someone, forgive as the Lord forgave you. Jesus not only had the power to forgive, but to grant us the ability to forgive others, just as we have been forgiving. Forgiving others often starts as a decision of surrender act of our will. This surrender invites God to begin working in our lives in a deeper level, allowing God to heal us, just as with the two tenors. We can ask God to enlighten us with the understanding that we need to fully forgive from our hearts. We simply need to make the choice to be open to forgiveness and reconciliation. Remember, forgiveness does not justify the deed or the person. It does not provide God's forgiveness for their actions, because only God can do that. While nothing can undo the past, we can do something about the condition of our own present and future. Forgiving others makes a way for our own healing to forgive. Brothers, my sisters, if you are willing to forgive, but you are unsure how, I want you to get your strength from this.
You can sing along if you want, okay? What do you think? We have all sinned. And to serve God's judgment. God the Father sent His only Son to satisfy the judgment for those who believe in Him. Jesus, the Creator and eternal Son of God, who lived a sinless life, loves us so much that He died for our sins, taking the punishment that we deserve, was buried, and rose from the dead. According to the Bible, if you truly believe and trust this in your heart, receiving Jesus alone as your Savior, declaring Jesus as Lord, you will be saved from judgment and spend eternity with God in heaven. What is your response? Would you pray this prayer of liberation and freedom in your heart? Join me. Dear Jesus, you know I've been hurt by others. You know that my resentment makes us act in ways that have been unreasonable and help and adhere. I need your power to release and forgive those who've hurt me so I can stop letting them control me. Would you please replace my heart with the peace of Jesus Christ? God, I realize that I've hurt a lot of other people with my habits and my bad decisions and my hang-ups. Would you please forgive me for the I've hurt others? Help me to make a list of those I've hurt, I've harmed, and in the right way, at the right time, to humbly seek to make amends. Jesus Christ, I want to refocus my life on you. I want to face the future courageously with love and peace in my heart. Would you replace my resentment with your love, my bitterness with your grace? Thank you for your graciousness to me. Thank you for forgiving me for the things that I've done wrong. In Jesus' name. We will now go to the second part of our short recollection. Please all stand. Let us sing for solitaries. Well done.
Oh, salutaris hostia, recelita is hostium, et apremum hostia.
Let us all together pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you for the gift of life. I thank you for sending your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to the world to save, to set me free. I trust in your power and grace
that sustain and restore me. Loving Father, touch me now with healing hands. I believe that your will is for me to be well in mind, body, soul, and spirit. Cover me with the most precious blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, from the top of my head to the soles of my feet. Cast out anything that should not be in me. Root out any unhealthy and abnormal cells and multiply my healthy cells. Open any blood, arteries, or veins and build and rebuild and the blemish and damaged areas. Let the fire of your healing love pass through my entire body to heal my diseased areas so that my body will function the way you created to be. That's also my mind, my memories, and my emotion, even the deepest recesses of my heart. Saturate my entire being with your presence, love, joy, and peace, and draw me ever closer to you every moment of my life. And Father, fill me with your Holy Spirit and empower me to serve you so that my life will bring glory and honor to your holy name. I ask this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, through the intercession of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. Amen. Please be seated. At this very short moment, we will be having the healing. We will be receiving the healing from God through the Blessed Sacrament.
believe and be healed.
Thank you.
Let us have the proclamation all together. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, by the power and love of Jesus Christ, our Lord, I know, I believe, that my prayers are being heard right now. And in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, by the power of his death and resurrection, by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, and the powerful intercession of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, and the intercession of all the angels and saints, I know and I believe and I claim that I am already healed in my mind and in my heart, in my body and in my spirit, in my memory and in my relationship, and in my financial difficulties as well. I know I am already healed, and I praise and thank you, Lord Jesus, for you are indeed a powerful, a merciful Savior. Amen. Let us all sing, Lord, I offer my life altogether.
I'm ready.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thank you,
God. Maraming salamat po sa inyo lahat at magandang hapon po.
Thank you very much for coming. And you know what? We still have some food at the back. If you're hungry,
yeah.